Hi everyone. It's lovely to be addressing you with respect to a topic on which is given to me today, which is motivation for company secretary students. So who is this person who is addressing you? Let me introduce myself. I am Rama Devi Iyer. I've been in this profession for more than 20 years now. Been in practice for almost 18 years. And as of now, I'm consultant to several companies and also very, very interested in academics. And that's how I am in front of you. I love talking to students and seeing whether I can help them in some way. Because I do believe that students are stressed and they are in need of motivation. So with that brief, very brief background, let us go on to the topic of the day. What is motivation? What exactly do we mean? That's the starting point, isn't it? In anything that you want to do, you should have a basic interest to do. Suppose I tell you that you do this. Will you be really interested? It has to be internal, isn't it? So this internal interest to do is what is motivation all about. So then I'm saying that there is an eagerness. What eagerness is this? Eagerness is to achieve something. So what have I achieved and how did I reach where I am? It is because I am eager to achieve something, isn't it? So I have a goal in mind. So there is an interest because I am interested to do what I am doing. Second is the eagerness because I have a goal in mind. Without a goal, you are not driven. You will not drive yourself. Drive yourself in what sense? You will not work hard enough. So if you don't work hard enough, just by thinking, oh, I will become a scientist one fine day, will you become? Not really. So you should have the interest to become a scientist, one. Then you should be eager to become a scientist, that's two. That eagerness will drive you to do hard work, day in and day out. Look at those cricketers. Look at those person like Sachin Tendulkar. Even at the age of 40, how he was driven to get a century, isn't it? What prompted him? What drove him? It is motivation. So ultimately, this motivation in him to achieve that double century, that single century, that 29th century, whichever, was what prompted him to practice. That's exactly the thing that you need to remember, that this hard work is what made him what he is. It is not only the intelligence, it is not only an inborn talent, ultimately it is hard work which will make you achieve. So this one point you need to remember. So these three go together. So then you will ask me, I don't have any motivation to achieve anything. But then if somebody else tells me, I'm interested. So does it work? My question to you is, if I'm not interested, if my mother tells me or my father tells me only I will do, how long will that work? Will it really work? I would like you to think about this. I would like you to answer that question. So an exam is about to come up and my mother or my father keeps on telling me that work on it, sit and study. After the fifth time, I guarantee you, I'll give it in writing if you want on stamp paper, you will get irritated and blow back. I'm not going to study, do what you want. Agree? So what is the reason? The motivation is coming from them. Motivation is theirs. They want you to do. That won't work. Ultimately, you have to think and you have to feel, yes, I must get ready for this exam. Yes, I must do well in this exam. Why? Why is where we are going to come up next. So why did you join the CS course? Ultimately, you are looking at a career, isn't it? If you were not looking at a professional career, would you be thinking of a CS course? You may have thought of a CA or a CS or a cost accountant or many of the other professional courses. I'm not saying this is the only course, but this is one of the courses which will get you into a career straight away. It launches you. It's a launching pad, isn't it? So think about it. as a BCom or a BSc or any graduation level, you may not be looking at a job directly. But then when you think about a CS, you may be thinking, yes, one, it will give me a sense of satisfaction because it is something which I always wanted to do. Like corporate laws is something which I always wanted to do, right? Therefore, I joined CS course. And that is the place I want to work. You must remember what Steve Jobs said. Steve Jobs said, if you love what you're doing, you will never have to work even one day. So if this is what you really love, if this is your motivation to join the CS course, because you love corporate laws, you love securities laws, you love all the Competition Act and all the different acts, you want to dissect it, you want to work in it, yes. You are linking it to a career ultimately. You are saying that my career is this, therefore I will never work even a single day. So you must identify, why did you join? Did you join because of the need to join a CS course? Or there was some, what was the real goal behind it? What were those things which incentivized you? What are those things which made you think, yes, this is the course to join and I don't want to do other courses. I want to do only CS. There should have been some reason. Think about it and keep that goal in mind. Why? I don't know how many of you have seen your MasterChef. Somewhere around the 8th or 9th or 10th episode, you will start seeing people break down because of the continuous pressure that is built up in the MasterChef, isn't it? When you look at that, it should strike you that you are somewhere in the same position now. Because you have joined it, you're somewhere in the middle, you're about to write an exam and you want to give up, right? So this thing, what the people who are handling the MasterChef, they tell you is, think about your goal, revisit your goal. Why did you join? What are those incentives which made you join? Is it a good career, a good position in life? Maybe it will lead you to a good salary. It will lead you to a good house. Whatever the reason may be, whatever is your goal, keep that goal in mind. Maybe write it down in a big letter in front of you somewhere, paste it on the cupboard which you use every day and look at it. Yes, this is why I joined. That will motivate you. That goal will keep you going. That is one tip. So then I have realized, okay, I need this CS degree. So what should I do about it? I have to pass the exams. So how to pass? Now I find it difficult. There is only one answer to that. The answer to that is you have to work hard. And you have to work on a continuous basis. There is no shortcut to this. It is not that I am very motivated by your talk, madam, today. So I am going to work very hard from tomorrow. That tomorrow never comes. It has to be today. It has to be now. Then only you will be able to work. So start working hard right now. That is one. What is the other tip? The other tip I would say is, you have to do it on a daily basis. It's not as if I have worked today and tomorrow I don't want to work. It is not fun. That doesn't work. You eat today, right? You also sleep today. So tomorrow we'll skip eating and sleeping. Will that work? It won't. Our bodily systems will not work. The same happens for your mind. You need to give it a pattern. You need to give it a system. And you need to tell it, you have to work every day from this time to this time in order to reach that ultimate goal. Another tip for with respect to passing in the exam is, you have to revise your concepts from time to time. It is not enough to study. Say I have done the lesson 1 in January. For the June exam, I have done the lesson 1 in January. And then I will not touch that lesson 1 till May because madam has said revision time is May. Will it work? it will not work, because those concepts are the foundation stone for every other chapter that comes later. So at least once in a while, go back to it, glimpse it. It doesn't take time to look at the concepts. So that time to time looking back is essential, because then only what we call in Sanskrit or Hindi, we say abhyasa. Abhyasa is required. Daily, mulling over it, daily looking at things back. That is very essential. And then, of course, to pass, you need self-motivation. I'll be coming to it again and again. You need to motivate yourself, because somebody else telling you is not going to do the trick. So how to pass? I have to think, I can do it. Only when you think, I can do it, it will work. If I tell you, you can do it, yes, it will work up to a point. After that, it should convert itself to self-motivation. You have to motivate yourself. Yes, I can do it. Yes, I have passed. Yes, I have come up to 12th standard, or I have done up to graduation. So what is the big deal? This is just another exam. So I can do it. That's how you motivate yourself. And then when it becomes very difficult on you, when you get very tired, you can come to one of us and ask us. And we will motivate you. So that little bit of dose is required once in a while, but generally motivate yourself. One more thing which will motivate you is to think what you want to achieve after the exams. When I teach for CS students, I always tell them, don't think only of exams. We are not here only to get that certificate, isn't it? We are here to become a professional. So after becoming a professional, what happens? Is it that we only want to pass this exam? Or is it that I am becoming a professional because that is my dream? Or is it that I want to study something new? That is why I am studying this course. Or is it that I am only wanting to earn money? So for earning money, you don't need to become a professional. So why are you here? You want to become a professional because there are certain concepts behind it, some thought process behind it. That also you need to keep in mind. We are not here only to pass. One of my teachers told me, one of the things that you need to do is to dream big. Why dream big? Because then only you will achieve something in life. If you say, okay, I just want a job. I just want a fixed income. That's it. I just want to live my life, have fun. Is that all? Is that all that you want to achieve? Really? I don't think that is what you should be thinking of. If you are a professional, you need to become the best professional there is in this world, in this particular field. And everybody should be hankering to come after you. Then only you have really achieved, right? You should become a Sachin Tendulkar. You should become a Amitabh Bachchan, right? Everybody is running after them. Why are they doing that? Because they have become the best there is in their field. You can take any example. You should become a Steve Jobs. You should become a Bill Gates. Why? Because they are the best in the field. So become the best in your field. That should be your dream. And that is what you want to achieve. It's not only to pass. This is one tip which I want to give you. So that should motivate you more than any other thing in this world. Because I want to be the best. I want to do the best in this field. Everybody should come after me for this work. They should not even think of a second person. Right? That's your motivation to become a professional. Not anything else. Others will come. The level will come. The position will come. The money will come. Everything comes. The fame will come. The name will come. What will not come is your level. Your level only you can create. It's like your knowledge cannot be taken away. Everything else can be taken away from you. But this knowledge which you are building up cannot be taken away. And therefore, you should garner as much knowledge which is useful for the exam as well as for the professional life thereafter. That's one point which I wanted to make to you. Now let me take you through. I started with a gung-ho. I said, yes, this is what I want to do. I'm totally motivated by what you said, madam. But then, after some time, I lost interest. Now, what do I do? What is the reason for losing this motivation? Because somewhere, after 2 to 3 months of continuous effort, you feel enough. Bahut ho gaya. I don't want to do anymore. You know, it's too much. Every single day, I'm working like a dog. I want to take a break. I want to give up. I don't think I will be ready for the exam. Very often students come up and tell me for June exam in sometime in April end. April is the best month for the June exam. Because invariably I'll have students coming up and telling me, Madam, I'm not ready for the exam. I'm going to give up. I'm not going to give this exam. I'll give it in December. You know what I would tell them? Immediately, don't give up. You are ready. It is just the last bit. It is like a marathon. How do you do in a marathon? You will keep running slowly in the first few miles, isn't it? And the last bit, what you should do? Should you give up? I am tired. Is that what you should do? Not really. What you should do there is to do that last sprint. That is the time they get motivated. Why? Because the end goal is in sight. So be like the marathoner who has that end goal in sight, the last lap. The last lap is the May or the November, December month before the exams. You cannot give up at that time. That is the time you lose motivation. Be aware of it. That's the first step. You will keep saying, okay, I'm tired now. I'll do it tomorrow. No, don't do that. The marathoner doesn't stop running at that point, does he? Then whatever he has built up will be lost. He won't be able to move at all. Have you observed what they do? They may slow down little bit, but they will not stop. Same way, you can slow down little bit. Maybe take a day's break. Maybe go to a movie and come. No problem. That will rejuvenate you. Whatever rejuvenates you. For me, what helps me is just stopping my work and just taking a break. Just reading some books. That rejuvenates me. Each person is different. So this is natural. Accept it. First step. Second step, rejuvenate yourself. Give yourself a nice one day off. Don't go to late night parties or anything. If you want, you can meet up with friends, relatives, whoever. Whatever makes you happy, do that on that one day. And then come back to it. Get back to the grind. Think. It's only a month more. You have done for 4 months. The big one is over. The mouse has gone. Only the tail is left, right? So that tail ke liye don't give up. So keep going. Keep doing. And the worst part of losing the motivation is coming from the relatives or peers. They may also tell you, you cannot do it. You are worthless. You are not up to it. There are enough people to tell you. There are good people who will tell you, you can do it. And there are a lot of people who will say, you cannot do it. And then how do you tackle that? That, how do you tackle is, you use what I call the 90 degree principle. What is the 90 degree principle? You take it into your ear, then only there is a problem, no? You barrier it here itself, let it go from the top. So it comes from here and goes out, 90 degrees. Use it, it works. Believe me, don't take it to your heart at all, no? Let them keep on saying whatever they want. It's all right. You keep going. Have the strength of mind to withstand that. And how do you do it? For better motivation, you need to change your thought process. Don't depend on others. Depend on yourself. And how do you change the thought process? First step, continue the effort. Don't stop. No matter what. Remember the marathoner. Second step, talk to those seniors or teachers or peers who are really interested in you, who are really your well-wishers. Identify them. Don't talk to the people who are only sugar on top and who will not give you the bitter pill where required. Your teachers or your seniors who are really your well-wishers may give you a bitter pill at times saying that work harder. It hurts you, but it will make you. And that is what is required at this time. The third thing is, as I said, take a break of 1 or 2 days, rejuvenate yourself, do what makes you happy and come back. Fourth step, look at your goal again. What made you join? Keep looking at it. That will really help you. Write it in big words. And that will keep driving you to work harder and harder. And you must think, empower yourself. How do you empower yourself? Empower yourself with your knowledge. Don't depend on others. Depend on yourself. And you have what one student named it for me. They said, Google Chacha. You have your Google Chacha, no, to help you. And we are all there to help you. There are people like us who really care about you, who really want you to do well, who want you to become the next professional. You should become better than me. That will be my real victory. So there are people like me all across who are really interested in you. And believe that. Believe in this positively. Have that positive attitude. The moment your attitude becomes negative, I'm told there are chemicals in your system, isn't it? All those chemicals are activated. The bad chemicals get activated and destroys your system. So it's very essential to have a positive attitude. You should think, yes, I can do it. Yes, I will pass. Yes, I will get the best job in the world. I'll be the best professional. And you must remember, you have come this far. You cannot leave it. You should never give up something which you have started. That is your key to success in life. You have to keep at it. Sometimes things are difficult. Sometimes there are hurdles. But keep chipping at it. You know that story about that water dripping, isn't it, on a stone? The stone was laughing, saying that this water dripping will not hurt me. What it was really afraid of was a waterfall. But this water, the dripping water, drop by drop on the stone, one fine day the stone cracked at that point. It is like that. So that's how you have to work. You have to keep on hitting at the same point. Eventually you will succeed. So let us talk about failure, another issue related to motivation. Why am I talking about failure in a motivation lecture? Because there have been people who have failed at times, including me, right? We have failed in different forums. We have failed in different exams. It is all right. It is all right to fail. So what are the types of failure we are talking about? We are talking about a very temporary kind of failure, isn't it? It's an exam failure. So, okay, one exam you fail. Big deal. There are enough exams in this world to be written, isn't it? So you have failed earlier. So what? Doesn't mean you will always fail. Failure is only a starting point. I am not going to use the cliche which is normally used that it is a stepping stone to success. It is. But let me give you a different viewpoint. I am going to say that failure is a starting point. It only makes us stronger. Why? Because when we have failed, we become harder. We become stronger. And we are determined. We definitely believe that we can do it and we determined to do it. How does that help? That helps in building our willpower. So what you should do if there has been a failure, you should focus on how to learn. How to learn? Madam, I don't know how to learn. So we have another video recording on that, which is going to tell you what is the study pattern. With respect to, or for those students who are with us, right? What is the best probable pattern which will integrate every possible product which has been given by us? That's one. What is the other thing which will help you? Other thing which is going to help you is scheduling. I don't know how to schedule. I think many of us are in that position. So that also, we have another video recording which will help you probably to schedule how the learning process into the entire system that you have, whatever work that you are doing. The key, however, is to focus on the reasons for failure. You must identify. You must be able to face it and then decide, okay, this is the reason for failure. Either you have left a few chapters or you didn't go deep enough, or you didn't revise, or it is possible that you have not been able to identify, it is possible that you didn't present properly, it could be any reason, isn't it? So how do you identify? One is you can talk to someone and find out what could be the reason, or you eliminate it yourself after identifying. So if I know I have not presented it properly, I should learn the presentation skills, isn't it? So believe in yourself, you can do it, and you can win, and you can succeed. So how do you face that failure? It's not the end of the world, that's what I said. And it is an opportunity, think of it as an opportunity to understand the same subject in a deeper way, in a better way. Think that failure is not a reflection about you. It is only that that particular knowledge has not been strong enough. So that knowledge has to be strengthened. It's not that you are a failure. It is just that you who have attempted this particular exam, that particular exam you have failed. Does it mean that you have failed as a person? No. Is it a reflection on you as a person? No. So what you should do? You should take it as a challenge and say, okay, this is it. This subject cannot defeat me. I will take it as a challenge. I will beat the subject. I will do the best possible. I'll probably ace the subject because I want to prove that I can do it. And that's your key for facing failure. Another one aspect more with respect to motivation, which I wanted to talk to you about, is about giving up. You cannot give up. You cannot ever quit. Why? Because the moment you quit, you have lost. It is immediate reaction. There are three indices to motivation, remember. One is choice. You have made the right choice. There is a goal. Then you do the effort for it. And then you persist in that effort. Continuous hard work, right? Moment you quit, you have given up on everything. And then it is difficult to build up your willpower to come back also. You have to expect excellence in yourself. You must say that I can do better than this. I can do one more. You have seen those people in athletics who do that high jump. And how with the bar when they do, each time they try to better themselves, that's how you should be. Those athletics, those sports persons are really inspirational, the way they keep trying to improve on their own records, isn't it? Keep trying to beat the records. Why? Because they expect excellence from themselves, not from others. Why? Because each person is unique. Each person has got the ability. Each person can do well. Don't believe others when they say you're not as good as your brother, as your sister, as your friend. Never compare with others. Even if others do, just 90 degrees. Believe that. You should set short-term goals. Ultimately, you'll reach the long-term goal, which is what scheduling will help you in. Ultimately, you must motivate yourself to get up and fight. What are you going to fight? Are you telling us to take a sword, madam? No. Fight in this battle, which is your battlefield. Your battlefield is this exam right now. So get up. Get up. You can do it. And ultimately, you can achieve what you set out to achieve. So the few things which I told you is motivate yourself. Don't compare with others. Never give up. Never even think about the past failures. That should strengthen you. And you can keep going. You motivate yourself. Ultimately, it's a goal. Keep the goal in mind all the time. Make effort. Make a continuous effort. Persistent effort will pay. You can do well. You are the best in your field and you can achieve it. Thank you.